ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the annual Canfield Winter Concert. At this time, we ask you please silence all cell phones and other electronic devices. Also, please be aware that flash photography is prohibited. In case of emergency, mark and link exit signs are located in the rear of the theater. Thank you for coming, and please enjoy the show. And now, for the introduction of the Canfield Bands, with director Mr. Canfield.
Thank you. being here this evening to help us celebrate the Music in Our Schools Month event. The National Association for Music Education has been sponsoring in the month of March, going back to the mid-1970s, a special time of year just to acknowledge the great things that happen in the world of music education all throughout schools across our country. Last week, we had a fantastic choir concert, a performance by our choirs here that was accompanied by a 30-piece orchestra as well. Again, just kind of showcasing the wonderful things we have in every area of our music department here, not just the band department. Tonight is our portion, and we are sort of using this as an opportunity to perform in front of people before we have to perform in front of people again on Friday at our district contest. Pretty much every student in both bands, this will be our first time doing sort of the full contest experience where we have to perform three select numbers, one of which has to come from a list, so we have to pick from kind of what the OMEA committee tells us to play. We'll pick the other two pieces, and then actually the last portion of it is a sight reading, where we go right from the stage and we perform these three numbers, we go into a different room, and literally sight read a piece of music we've never seen before in front of a judge. So we'll actually have an opportunity tonight to do that with both groups where I can explain a little bit more how that process works. But before we get to that point, that was our first number called The Light Eternal. That was from our Class B list that the OMEA puts out each year. Traditionally, in the past, this group has been Class C, so Class AA being the highest, Class A being the next level, and then so on and so forth down the alphabet. But in the fall, getting ready for our winter concert, for our original holiday concert in December, this group did a really nice job preparing and rehearsing, and it really kind of gave me the hope that Class B, something they haven't done in a long time, would be a possibility. So we decided to kind of embark on that journey together, and they're off to a pretty good start. Hopefully, we only got 48 hours, so we got to do it for real. But I think we're off to a really good start with all three pieces, that one especially. This next piece was kind of our backup. It was on the Class C list, so if we decided to go to Class C, we sort of had this one in the bag ready to go. This is the Nathan Hale Trilogy. It's made up of three movements, so you'll hear us kind of stop in the middle. We'll kind of just flow away from one movement to the next. And after that, we will have our sight reading portion. So let's go back to the program. And again, I just want to thank you all for being here this evening. Thank you.
Thank you.
kind of let you see sort of a glimpse behind the curtain and get an idea for what this weekend actually is. So we're going to have Mr. Faye come out here in a second and pass out folders. This is pretty close to what the kids will experience on Friday when we go to Lake High School for a contest. So while he is passing those out to the section leaders, the section leaders are wondering, hey, let Mr. Faye know where you are. When we perform at Lake High School, we'll perform on their stage in the Performing Arts Center. And then right as soon as we're done with these three pieces, we walk straight into another room, sit down, and it's going to be very similar to this sort of folders of music we've never seen before will be passed out to the students. And there's kind of a strict outline of how this process works. So it starts with a slight introduction with the rules and kind of the process from the judge. There's one judge at this point, three judges are listening to our select pieces. And then we had a 4-minute period of basically it's like silent meditation. Everybody in the band and myself sort of looks through the music, gets an idea, and kind of, you know, cranks for the test. We need to kind of see trouble spots, things we might need to want to pay attention to, anything we were not sure of, schools we're not familiar with. But we had 4 minutes where everyone sort of silently looks through the music and I get to look through the score. And then there's another 4-minute period where we get to sort of quickly rehearse some of those trouble spots. So as soon as I get that opportunity, I'll start saying, I'll pay attention to this, go ahead and practice through this. The tricky part is we're not allowed to play at all during these 2 4-minute periods. So if we practice anything, it might just be kind of slight little vocalizations, but nothing on the instrument. So we're not allowed to make any sound until the first downbeat of the actual performance. After the 4 minutes are up, the second 4 minutes are up, then we'll say, time, then we start, and that's it. After the performance, the judge will give us some feedback in terms of how we did, things that went well, things that maybe we need to pay attention to for the future, and then all 4 judges will supply us with a rating. We're going to sort of simulate that here in a second. I'm going to basically say time. We're going to do sort of a quick, maybe 2 or 3 minute period at the beginning where everyone gets to look at their parts, maybe 2 or 3 minutes where I get to give them a rundown, and then you get to hear the world premiere of the Canfield High School concert band performing our recycling piece. So like I said, just give us a few minutes, we're gonna go through it. I get to kind of guide you through the second portion of it. So again, this is sort of the juice, be behind the curtain for what the process is like. Thanks. allowed to give out measure numbers or kind of say, hey, here's where we're at, make sure you do this. So during the actual performance, I'm allowed to give some clues and sing parts. So I can tap it if I want to, don't worry, I probably won't. No guarantees though. But it's just kind of, again, a way to sort of see what the foundational level of each ensemble is, okay? Hopefully we're never going to be called the day of a concert or a cycle or anything. But usually with this, it's just to see, okay, we heard the three numbers that they've been working on for 2 months. Now what can they be? How musical can they be in a moment's notice? It's very, very tricky. Again, none of the students in either band have done the cycle portion before. That was something that got rid of by the wayside after COVID. But it's coming back this year. It's the first year they're doing it again. So I think for their first run through, we did a simulated version this last week. One of our favorite professionals, Mr. Young, came in. But I thought they definitely did a wonderful job for, again, cycling their portions. So I have one more round of applause. All right, we're going to close this portion of the program with our final number. There's a march entitled Scholastics, another number that requires a lot of finesse and a lot of attention to detail. Again, this group has done a really fantastic job of getting a lot of the finer points of music to come through. Well, thank you again for supporting both ensembles sitting around the entire program. We hope you enjoy Scholastics. We have two ensembles performing for you outside of our concert in Symphonic Band. We're going to have our percussion ensemble get set up shortly here in the front. First concert band is going to pack up, and then the first chair players, you can take the sight reading folder with you. I will collect those at the end. Okay? So concert band again, we're just going to file out in this front portion one row at a time. We're going to kind of move some equipment around, but we'll be right back with our Symphonic Band percussion ensemble. Thank you again. So, back at the end of January 28th, we had the OBA solo ensemble event at the District 5 event. Covers all schools in Mahoning, Trumbull, and actually Beulah County. So they all sent soloists and quartets, percussion ensembles to competition. Out of those three counties, Canfield had the most participants. We had 47 different events over the course of that Saturday. Of the 47, we had 38 superior ratings, meaning that's the highest you can get. The ones that were not superior rating were all excellent ratings, which is the second highest rating you can get. So we had a fantastic showing of all of our students that day out at Warren Kelly High School. One of our many ensembles that performed exclusively well that day is standing in front of you now. This is our Symphonic Band Percussion Ensemble. They are performing the Allegro movement from Einhorn and Knock Music. They were one of the many groups that received a superior rating on Saturday the 28th, and we are, again, very excited to be using our school's theme to show you, again, just sort of the rest of the elements of our program that goes so well day in and day out. So without further ado, I present to you the Symphonic Band and Percussion Ensemble. Thank you. As I said before they perform, first of all, another round of applause for our percussion. As I said before, we had a lot of wonderful groups perform that day back in January. The first one we had to go in the morning was our brass quintet, who I'm going to introduce you shortly. Now, it's always a bit of a roll of the dice when you get the 8 a.m. spot or the 8:10 spot of solo ensemble. You never know if the coffee's kicked in yet for the judge or for the students. You never know how awake everyone's going to be, if they're a little grumpy because they're an evening person, if she's drove a long way to get here. So you never quite know how it's going to go. But I was very pleasantly surprised by how the brass quintet and how well they performed on that 8:10 time slot, I believe. No surprises seeing them rehearse on the other side of my office wall quite a bit at the end of that event. They sounded wonderful. They did a really, really nice job preparing us on their own. A lot of the times, these ensembles that do so well are all led by the students. Occasionally, we'll get some of our prepared professionals help run some of the rehearsals. But 9 times out of 10, they're really putting it together themselves. This group is in that category as well. At this time, I would like to introduce the 5 members of our symphonic band quintet, our brass quintet. Help me welcome them to the stage, please.
Thank you.
as always, have another round of applause for our quintet. All right, we're going to do our final set change of the evening. We're going to get the chairs and stands for the quintet away, and the symphonic band is going to join us for their portion of the program on stage. We'll be right back in short. Thank you. But this first selection, the English Folk Song Suite, is another three movement piece, and this is the one that we had to pick from the list to qualify for Class A with this group. So again, three movements, a slight break in between, and we're just going to transition right from one to the next. But again, this is the Canfield High School Symphonic Band performing the Folk Song Suite. Symphonic Band's turn to go through the site reading readers. For concert band, I cut those 4 minute periods down to about 3 minutes or so, just to kind of get things moving along a little bit more, to do the same thing here. So there's a little bit quicker, a little more accelerated time span at the beginning there. This group has really, really, I mean, we've been spending a lot of time focusing on a lot of little details. Over the last week alone, we brought in a lot of different people, kind of outside experts, to help work with the kids and really kind of give a different opinion of how things are going. Last Monday, I was able to bring in the brass faculty quintet from the University of Akron to come and do some sectional work with our kids. This past Friday, I was able to have Dr. Buckler from Ensemble State University come in and work with our students. Last Wednesday, Mr. Young, our trumpet paraprofessional and retired band director from Lakeview, came in and worked with our students. And we have our usual cast of characters in our paraprofessional category who do a wonderful job with our students day in and day out. They are all listed in the program this evening, but I do want to give a round of applause. I know a few of them are in the audience tonight who are paraprofessionals. Without them, what you hear on stage wouldn't be possible. So how about a round of applause for our paraprofessionals? It's a really special thing. We have so many paraprofessionals who are retired band directors, and it really is a special thing that they finally made it to retirement, and the first thing they want to do is come back and work with kids. And not just any school, they choose to come here and work with our students and with our program. So I think that speaks volumes to the tradition that's here, and has been for a long time, the quality of education that your students get here. So again, with the theme of music in our schools, emphasizing quality music education in schools, in my opinion, be a little extra biased these days. I think Canfield's got a pretty special thing going on. So I just want to thank anybody else who might not be in the program who supports our program and our kids day in and day out. Obviously all of you, parents, family, and friends who drive your students to lessons, to and from lessons, to rehearsals after school, football games on Friday nights. Again, you are just part of this process as the students are and the teachers are. So thank you for your constant support of your students and of our program. Again, we are going to take a look at another site reading piece here. We are going to get that process started again. I'm going to speed it up a little bit so we can get through that and get to our final number this evening. But again, this is the site reading portion for Symphonic Band. Thank you. appeasing us there, getting another opportunity for students to go through the sight reading process. Like I said, it's part of our performance on Friday. So it's really nice to have a run-through of this in front of an audience. I don't know what would be more stressful, performing in front of a couple hundred people like we are tonight, or the one single judge we'll have on Friday. One set of eyes staring at the ensemble the entire time. No pressure, it'll be great. But it really is a stressful process, and trying to put a song together in 4 minutes is quite an endeavor for sure. I thought they did a wonderful job. Let's hear it one more time for us. Before we perform our final number of the evening, I want to thank you all again for coming out here and supporting music in our schools, not just tonight, but pretty much every day of the year. So again, thank you for everything you do. Like I said, even if your role is just making sure your student gets here on time for performances, that's a big part of it. So you're all really helping to make this program the best that it can be, so thank you very much. On your way out, just like most concerts, we have our donation fund for our sheet music fund. Again, when we have all these different required pieces for contests, obviously, you know, we own most of them, we might sell to purchase some, so that goes a long way towards ensuring that every year, after year, our contest goes as well as it possibly can. So if you are so inclined to do so, we really appreciate any donation on your way out. Again, this is our last number of the evening. Thank you for being a wonderful audience, and this is March Gloria. Thank you again. Thank you. May 4th at our spring concert. Thank you again. Have a good evening.